Imagine sledding down a mountain at 75 miles an hour. Imagine doing it while sitting on a snow shovel. Shovel racing is becoming a world-class sport, but don't look for it at the Winter Olympics. Action 7 News Network reporter Matthew Hill found it at Angel Fire.
This competition is serious business, not to mention a thrill for pilots and crew.
Racing is racing, and anybody that races knows the adrenaline rush, and it's quite a deal. It's legal.
These slick sledding machines resemble bobsleds, but the roots of shovel racing sit here, literally. This is the traditional shovel racer used in the annual World Championships held at Angel Fire. But competitors in the high-tech sleds must also sit on a shovel. You may be wondering where the shovel is on these racers. Well, here it is right down here. The rules say it must touch the snow and be no more than 12 inches from the driver's seat.
One, go.
Well, we built the lightest sled out here this year, 120 pounds. And I think it's pretty aerodynamic, so we should be fast.
When these go-karts on snow hit the slopes, there's more than aerodynamics at work. There's the pilot's driving skill.
It's all gravity. They don't have any motors on the back of these. They just try to stay in the center of the course, stay away from the walls, and let it all hang out here at the 25th Annual World Shovel Race Championships here in Angel Fire.
Great. Will you come in to race for us?
You betcha. We got Mark Bradford up at the top of the course. He's got a nice line. He takes it straight down the middle. You've got about 600 pounds of locomotion coming right at you. 14.867 was his first time. He bettered it for his second run with a time of 14.674.
But not good enough to beat the top speed of 13.80 seconds. At Angel Fire Ski Area, Matt Behill, Action 7 News Network.
And the shuttle pilot who reached the top speed was Gail Boles. He won for the third year in a row. Incidentally, traditional shovel racers do not compete against those high-tech sleds. They are in separate divisions. Looks like fun.
It is, I bet.
Well, when I was a kid and Dad handed me a shovel, I didn't exactly consider it a recreational vehicle. But Lee Faria's got the story of some people that do. It's off the beaten path. Can you dig it?
Okay. Three, two, one, go.
Right on course.
It's as big a part of New Mexico as finding a sky full of balloons in October. It's the annual shovel races at Angel Fire, when a couple of weeks ago, winter warriors gathered with scoopers in hand to see who had the swiftest shovel.
People hear about it on the internet, on the news, in the paper, and they say, hey, I can race a shovel. And they show up and they race down the shovel.
I know what you're thinking. What kind of person does this? Well, you have to be a little daring, a little crazy, and you have to have a need for speed.
We have kids from six and up racing from the top of the hill at speeds of over 50 miles an hour. I mean, the young kids. So the production race, anyone can really do that. All it takes is a snow shovel to spend a little time waxing it, giving it a little love.
The shovel experience began in 1966 and has since grown to include the modified division. Without a doubt, the best reactions always come from the rookies.
I put the goggles down and I had the helmet on and I really couldn't see or hear. I don't know what I was doing, so I didn't fall, so that's a good start.
And who knows? If curling can be in the Winter Olympics, maybe shovel racing has a chance. At Angel Fire, I'm Lee Faria, off the beaten path.
Real important to wear that helmet.
Okay. Yeah, that's fun.
Interstate highway between Spokane, Washington and Angel Fire, New Mexico. We have one camera crew that will never ask directions. So it took them an extra 2 days to get to the 25th annual World Championship Shovel Races. These are serious racers whose only expense is to buy some streamlined underwear and a brain bucket. No high-budget ski or snowboard equipment is needed. They had prizes of exotic trips for the fastest time, as well as prizes for anyone who showed up with their first wife. The only restriction in this race is that the rider has to have a shovel in contact with the snow at all times. Lose contact with the snow, lose the race. Police radar showed a speed of 74 miles an hour, and it still wasn't fast enough to win. With a top speed of 77 miles an hour and an $8,000 home-built high-tech machine, Paul Boles became the world's shovel champion for the third year in a row. His first prize was a one-week vacation in Fresno, California. Second prize was a two-week vacation in Fresno, California.
service. Who are they?
Races 1998, the 25th edition, the silver anniversary. We're here, it's Friday. We're doing test runs of the modifieds. We've done some production test runs earlier. Course felt good. This is the locomotion. Oh, that was, oh!
65 miles an hour.
I think the skis just sort of fell off. An hour, Kermit Brown.
Wow, that's
good.
Here comes Corey Humphrey.
Humphrey.
Yeah, they got to get down there. They got to keep people on the course to get this one down the hill. That's for sure.
Why doesn't he just run it out?
Because this is, he wants to make sure it stops. He's never ridden it before.
Oh.
And
we're just slipped.
There you go. That's good. See, it's slowing down. Perfect. Steer it, doggy. Steer it. Get away from that wall. There you go. And it slowed down.
Oh, yeah. I could sit there.
Yeah. Awesome. Woo! How do you feel?
I feel great. I feel tight right now, though.
Okay. How do you feel, mister?
I feel great.
How was your test run? Give me the rundown.
Oh, it was very nervous at the beginning, but after I dug the brake in one time, I was good to go after that.
Yeah? And how did the brake work?
Oh, it pretty much dug in. They had to dig me out the first time, and then after I came down a little further, I was just barely tapping it, and it would just slow me down and then pick me back up, and I could keep going. It was great. I'm a lot more comfortable with it now.
How are you feeling sitting in the starting gate up there?
Numb.
Maybe. Numb? A little numb, but ready to roll?
Numb.
How about you, crew member?
I was throbbing, man.
Were you throbbing?
I was throbbing. I was worried, but yet I knew it was going to be all right.
What do you think our chances are on Sunday?
I think we got a good chance. It's going to be a good competition, though.
You'll be ready to let it rip, won't you?
It's going to be. Oh, I'm going to. Brakes going to work down here only.
Yeah. Yeah, you. It was
unless
beautiful.
In case of emergency, of course.
That was a gorgeous run, Corey. That's the best test run this sled's ever done. So, do you want to run that sled down and we'll watch the boys, see what our competition is?
Let's do it. I need to pound a beer real quick.
Yeah, let's do that. On course.
Here we go, folks. Larry Haley on course and watch him go. We're going to see if he's going to do a brake run or a speed run. Looking like he's letting it run.
Holy shit.
All I wore was that one layer of the lycra, and I pulled my shovel out. My ass burned so hard. My God, my whole butt was purple.
Yeah,
it was bad. Last couple years,
The reigning X Games gold medalist sled. Silver medal at Angel. Oh, there he goes. Shoot.
Okay, we've got too fast.
All right, here's Don's sled from last year.
Doing a brake test again.
Gold medalist sled.
I have a friend of Adam Austin.
He's just testing it, y'all.
Rob Villalobos sled, fire and ice, coming down the hill. Brian Turpin, he's making a run too.
We'll see how fast he comes down.
Oh,
nice break.
Buried.
Good spray.
That break is the best.
Yeah!
Well, he's never done it before. Well, next we got the virgin run of the Backdraft 2 here at Angel Fire. She had some very fast runs at the X Games. We got Pat Burgess, Bill Burgess's brother, three-time world champion many moons ago, in the sled. Here we go, on course.
Back in the center of the course, letting it run a little bit. Looks like we might have a speedy one here, folks.
Oh, look at it.
Oh, shit.
What shirt?
Oh. Oh, his nose is caught in up here. Back him up.
All right, Pat?
Holy
moly.
Oh,
yeah, everything, all my extenders are bad.
We're 10-4.
It almost feels like
he's 10-4.
Actually, it might have been.
Nothing.
Damn, y'all, we started seeing this thing started spitting parts. Like, whoa.
Yeah, you left your brake way back there.
You hit the brakes and it stayed there.
Well, the emergency didn't work either.
It almost did.
You know what's really bad?
I got a hole in my
neck. Halfway down, it was...
Nah, your net will be all right.
Do I have a hole in my neck?
I was fine at first, and then halfway down, I was... Nothing.
How do you feel, Pat?
I'm fine.
Came right down. Slam.
Stay back.
Oh, shit.
What shirt?
It's like coming down without any visibility.
You can't see that well?
It fogged up halfway down. I just... And I went, well, I think I'm straight. There wasn't any...
Well, lift the brake up.
I was afraid to hit the brake there.
Well, last year, they had the same fog stuff. They left on the
side. Okay, you're out of the net.
I don't know if it was the inside or that side. It may have actually been that.
We're going to have to go forward now.
Yeah, we're going to
have to go
forward. Wow, we have to go forward. Sure. I know that.
Let's roll. Let's lay it up on one side. Hang on.
Shit! I should have been behind the net for that. Boy.
Oh man.
Yeah, I'd say that bent that back a little bit.
Yeah, your brake is a little. Yeah. Here's the brake. That's carbon steel.
How do you feel, Pat? You all right?
I must have pulled a muscle when I when you hit those straps.
Yeah. So what did it feel like to you? I mean, when it just wire? Did you know the brake wasn't working or?
Well,
you
after it doesn't stop, I was going.
It's a dead giveaway.
I was thinking, you know, this brake doesn't seem to be behaving right.
Well, we can put any
wire. Let me look. I don't know if mine's still in
the... Oh, what do you want?
The plow just sheared right off.
Here, how about this extra strap?
Yeah.
Can just do it?
Bummer.
Yeah, we thought right when you put it down.
Yeah, everybody took off running.
Pat, you love to crash modified shovels. How many crashes is this for you?
I do not like the crash. And that's only,
three?
I mean, oh, wow, I did this too.
That's exactly what I did last year. It wasn't covered that well.
Red duct tape will fix that.
No joke.
It's this that you got to worry about.
We can get that straightened up. You can go back tomorrow.
73.
They had him clocked at the base here.
God, I was really hoping not to have to pull an all-nighter again.
Let's strain that ski out.
Well, we're going to have to cut this open here. We can duct tape this stuff.
Yeah.
Why did this side do it? Not that? Was I going a little sideways finally?
Yeah. Into it sideways.
It looked like a dead man break or something was...
Well,
really
I think it's one prong probably stuck more than another. Yeah.
Oh, so you fired the dead man?
Oh, yeah. And I didn't think it worked because it wasn't. I was banging slow, my foot in there, man. I was pushing everything.
It was slowing
I could.
You down. The dead man was.
When did it go on?
Hey, you can watch right the video
away.
On
right away? Okay, so I hit it the first try, but I couldn't.
Yeah, I could show you the crash right now.
It didn't feel like anything was happening. So I was going, whoa. Ready, I was just pumping it. I think that's too much toe in, guys.
Yeah. Now you're back one thing.
A little work tonight for you.
Sorry, had an intro with Brandon.
Yeah. Break. It's not squirrely. He's going straight.
No, he's
not.
He's squirrely.
But he's going. It's always that squirrely.
It's always squirrely.
Nice stop.
He's got a great stop.
It's definitely work, even though he started off a little early, but he's giving the thumbs up.
Rick Schrantz old sled. Here he comes. Okay, we got Don Adkins in his new sled. First time ever run. Just about to head out. Here he comes. On course. Four miles an hour for Don Adkins. A man in his sled. All right, we got Gail Boles, world champion, in his sled, Odin's Fire. First ever run. Let's see what we got. Come on, Gail. All right, Gail, on course. Come on, Boles. All right, it's working good. Let's give us some speed, Gail. Gail, maiden voyage. How do you feel?
Pumped.
Pumped? Tell me about the sled. How did it run? What did you think?
Ran really good. Hit the brake a million times. There was still plenty of gas left over. I think, let me check and see how much pressure. The sled was stable, but the run was fast. I only went about a quarter of the way. And you said I was doing 54?
Yep.
Man.
Pulling it up the hill.
I'm almost glad that this wasn't race day and we went from the very top. That would have been a 90 mile an hour run.
All right, you want to go up and take a 90 mile an hour? They'll let you take
really,
a second run.
Really fast. I don't know what I'm going to do with the fogging issue, man. Because
are you fogging up?
Well, look, my little shield wasn't even down, and it fogged instantly. So I don't know about having the cockpit fully on. I might just have to leave this one off. I don't know. We'll see, because I don't want fog.
Okay, we're here with Don Adkins. How you doing, Don?
I can't believe I'm going through this with you again.
Here we are, and I'm filming you again. He hates it. So what is the name of your sled? Have we named
really
the sled?
I haven't thought of anything at the moment.
You have no name for the sled?
We might name it after the boys' team, you know, home in there, the little school, the home bullet.
The bullet?
Yeah, so it might be
the bullet. The bullet will work. So tell me about your run. How did you feel?
Good. Steer's good. Brake works.
Brake work good?
It's going to be fast.
You feel tight in there and everything feels good?
I think it's going to be fast.
Think those skis will work for you? Oh, yeah. And we got speed skis on the other one, too. How'd you pull that off?
Scraps.
Snake. You snake. No, that's all right. I was going to give you a pair of skis anyways. I'd rather, I'd rather have the speed skis.
Actually, one of those is a little bent.
Really?
Lost the camber.
We won't tell anybody about that. So we got this. We got, what is this one called again? Snow time?
I don't know.
We don't have a name for either. No. We got a name on Big Guy. So here we go.
Keep it. Sure. And, I heard the brake.
Yeah.
But we had a crash into the net here.
Yeah, it's probably
he missed that. Took this guy right out. So what do you think happened here, Len? Tell me what just happened. We missed this all on video.
Our brake cultivator just didn't get into any snow.
Just didn't dig in?
No, he didn't dig in.
Maybe you were
the angle of it. You guys didn't have any trouble in California with the brake, except for ripping it out.
Dang.
Well, you got a different
setup. But you feel okay? How do you feel after that? How did that, I mean, when you hit, I mean, how do you feel? Are you sore anywhere? Did you crack your neck or anything? Damn.
You're fixable.
No.
I know the frame.
That was a lot easier taking a shot into that net than flipping a sprint car.
Yeah. I know what it feels like to roll many times. Yeah. I know what you mean.
No, that was a good ride. Finally got speed, though. That was what I was looking for.
Your tail end was sliding all over the place on the way down. What do you think was the cause of that?
The first run I did today was like 36 miles an hour, but I had rudders built into the monoboards to try to keep stability.
Yeah.
It worked like a brake, so it came off the hill real slow. So I pulled all
pulled
four,
those off.
Went half the depth of run canned the snowboards to where I had some inside edge to keep it stable.
Yeah.
But it still didn't stay stable.
Is your neck, everything all right? You're feeling
my
good?
My neck's a little sore.
A little sore? A little whiplashed?
Yeah.
Well, you slammed that neck good.
I broke it once, so.
Your neck?
Yeah.
Oy.
So that was probably going to be sore tomorrow.
Well, glad you're all right, man.
Yeah, no problem. I got
I'm there.
Good conditions today?
Yeah.
Like Lorenzo Lama says, if you look good, you feel good.
It's going to be faster than
you
we
look
think.
Look marvelous, darling.
Is that right?
Especially riding that grease fighting that Andy Dover gave, huh?
Hey, Andy, throw some sand on that, would you?
Ready to rock and roll.
Hell yeah.
What's up, Bobby?
What's happening, brother?
How you doing?
Very well. How's the conditions today?
Well, they're a little slow. A little powdery, a little snow. I think the heavier people might have a slight advantage, but I wouldn't count on it. I said, but I qualified. I said I won't count on it.
I'll never really say that.
Come on, Bulls. Let's see what you got.
Like Butch says, race what you brung.
I brung some extra weight right here.
Hey.
Yeah.
U-N.
Tony. Ultra Nectar. Look at you.
Whoa.
Yeah.
I was talking
to your sponsors.
Yeah, he's one of the sponsors. This is his. He's got the gear. He's fully geared out.
Of course. They lead a charmed life, Gail. I know. I heard about that. I can't wait till the hunt sees that.
Hey, where's the aisle?
Okay, who's gonna be?
What are you doing, Andy?
Bad.
Well, I'll get it off the thing.
Yeah,
I think you can see the picture of the thing.
Yeah.
Well, you're the man. You take care of it. He's the man.
He's the man.
Easy, easy. No, I ain't gotta tell him nothing.
Delicate.
Those suckers are slick.
No problema.
No problem.
No problema.
Claro que si. Claro que si.
Might be just in Andy.
You got lucky. Cool.
We used to always play down in the sub basement there, Chris.
Andy worked with that graphic or whatever, wiring with Tammy.
Gail? Yeah.
How you
doing,
man?
Tony.
How you doing?
The hat threw me off. I was like, who is this Soviet?
Yeah, Kamradsky. Kamradsky, I come to kick your butt. You know, racing speed. How you been, man?
Good.
All right. Did you go to the extreme game?
No, they banned us.
You went and protested.
I went and protested.
Yeah, we all had some really nice warm ultra nectar gear.
Whiskey with vitamin B.
Not that bad looking. It's really slow though. Wind's blowing up here.
I never get adrenalized doing
shots. 3, 2, 1, go.
Go, 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 go!
I can't breathe this stuff.
Ultra Nectar. Sorry, I'm sponsored by myself. I have to pay for this stuff.
I like that little shovel.
Thank you. It's a Tammy Dobos original.
What's that?
We'll be after the Masters.
There you go, Romero.
John, you're next.
All of us together. I have no idea. Hey, Gail, do you have any extra lead for my shoes?
John.
Sorry, bud.
No more lead?
Yeah,
boom. I'm unleaded. Sorry, no regular leaded for me.
You know, I entered two categories. They only gave me one bag. I'm going to go down and complain.
Corey got two bags.
Yeah, Andy, yeah, you want some duct tape for that?
What?
Here. Number. Oh, no, you're going to take that off.
But,
no, I'm going to wear these pants. Oh, are you? You should duct tape on because...
I got duct tape. Way too easy. Can I borrow some of that duct tape?
Yeah.
I mean, actually, can I have some?
Yeah.
I won't be giving it back.
I'll give it back, but you won't
want it. I don't want it back.
Those guys shine and quality.
Rose's butt, baby.
Ultra Nectars. Sponsoring World Shovel Race Champion.
You should go back to
Gail
the ride.
The
man from Ultranectar has also given Gail some of that testosterone, that bull testosterone.
Thought he might Red Bull. Pick me up.
Don't need it.
A little pick me up.
I'm overdosing testosterone.
Oh, she's
lay back.
Whoa.
Elbows.
Look at Gail.
Tape up my gloves.
He's got shit. Look at everything's like
chemo gloves.
I'm gonna rip right off.
They say we go get some chair. Can't stab him with the needle.
Okay. All right. That's just great for the viewers.
Drake, I like the Mad Max.
I like the undercover.
Ultra Nectar. Full testosterone.
You guys do two runs, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Get out of here.
The strategy.
Get away.
For her to go very, very fast. We've put Chevy Chase's speed secret on the bottom, and we fully expect for this to be like harkening back to the Christmas vacation days where sparks and stuff are flying, and she's going so fast, she's going to burn a hole right through the net.
Blast right through it.
Just blast it. Win the championship 2 years running, take a little prize home, a little money.
Sweet!
Speed 4-1. Speed is 6-0. About 30 minutes.
His number is 417.
Four 476.
417.
Yeah. Okay, if I don't know how I'll ever know that.
Just in case correct. You needed to know.
Good.
Yeah. Just your basic L1, high 8.
High 8.
52. 5-2. 5-2.
Johnny!
Champ isn't going to champ out this time.
5-1.
God, I've changed clothes 40 times today.
Just be thankful they're not wet.
Scott. Oh, there they are. In the dust.
Except for the net, because that means that you're out of control. The net rule has always been there.
No name of that flag. What is that? Flag.
Chris Jansen had a total of 8 rebounds, but 5 of them came on the offensive end of the
Notre
ball.
Day?
Here he crashes the board for the tip-in.
That's
a 6'5" forward. Can't Notre hurt you Notre like that. You have to put a body on him. Here at 7 foot, Ryan Chilton getting the garbage.
How you feel, Don?
This one's understandable.
Bad. you ready to race tomorrow? Don't worry. You are the man. All you gotta do is get me in there.
And Chris
Gray
is a bear on offensive board.
See what happens.
Block him out.
Rebounding may not be the most important stat in the book, but it's in the
Or Bowles, do you have any parting words to say for tomorrow's race?
It's an addiction.
need for speed, buddy. People that have never done it don't know. Those who have, most of them won't do it again, but it takes a certain breed of people that just wants to keep moving. I mean, I crashed on that light modified that I rode that first year. I came back and did it again. I crashed last year. A week later, I was back doing it again. And everybody thought, that guy is crazy. Hey, crazy guys win, I guess.
We are crazy. And Andy Dobos is here once again to make sure the skis are fast. Now, what do you think about the ski conditions for tomorrow's race?
conditions are very variable.
Well, it's the night before the big race, and obviously everyone's trying to get their sleds ready, so what you're about to see will be extremely wild.
I know it's sappy, but I'm getting to the point. Seems that most people love to watch those modified shovel racers, but some don't want them crashing at the party. Here's Lee Faria, off the beaten path.
Their stable run, maybe they changed the wax on the skis. Remember, there are four of them. This is pretty aerodynamic.
For the past 25 years, February has meant modified snow shovel racing at Angel Fire. 2 years ago, the New Mexico Ski Resort had to share the modified racers with ESPN's X Generation Olympics, the X Games. But this year's wild and wacky event told the shovel racers thanks, but no thanks.
A lot of the snowboarders complained about us because we got most of the press. They seemed to got pushed to the back burner, and I don't think they like that.
The shovel racers have called Angel Fire home for over two decades, and officials there plan on keeping the event officially theirs.
We've always had modified speed for the past 25 years. We'll continue to have them. And in fact, all the racers like our course and have told me yesterday how much they love our course compared to what they race to the X Games.
ESPN says it said goodbye to the shovel racers because the event wasn't wild enough, but that's not the popular take on the mountain.
A lot of it's probably liability. I mean, after a crash like mine, I think it scared them. I think they bit off a little more than they could chew, but we'd love to, you know, be invited back someday.
So from now on, we'll share chili, balloons, and technology with the rest of the world, but the shovel racers belong to us. At Angel Fire, I'm Lee Faria, off the beaten path.
I've always said that New Mexico is the most hospitable place in the nation.
We've always believed you.
Yes.
We welcome those shovel racers.
Thank you.
Gail Boles?
That's right.
Gail, tell us about this futuristic machine that you're driving.
This is the future of shovel racing. I got chrome moly tubing, custom rack and pinion steering, gas bottle. It's going to all be real safe. I was riding another sled that I went on the last 2 years, but it didn't really cover my head, and I wanted to have my head protected. That was the only thing I got knocked out for about 5 seconds last year when I went to the X Games. Went over the wall, did about 13 flips. But they told us it wasn't exciting enough. One person told us it's not. And then another person told me it was too dangerous. So, I don't know, they need to get their story straight or something. But I'll tell you what, you guys watch and judge for yourself whether you think it's exciting or not.
This is kind of a big sled, small sled strategy here today.
Oh, yeah. But, you know, I'll tell you, what's happened in the last year, okay, because we never had crashes like we did out there in California. It was, the course wasn't as wide as this. It was a different type of snow. I'd like to do the X Games again. I think we could probably work with them and make something to their liking, whatever. But now we have wrist restraints, leg restraints. I have a neck donut. All the sleds are passing a more rigorous inspection. Buddy of mine, I mean, 1,000 feet, and you're doing 80 miles an hour. I don't know how long a quarter mile is, but I'll tell you what, that's ripping from that short of course. So,
What about the snow today? A couple inches last night? Can I tell you?
We were taking snow temperatures all night. Worked on my sled last night till 4 in the morning. So I didn't make the 7 o'clock, whatever it was, get my sled up here. I think it's going to be fast. You know, it was a bit icy on Friday. I'm kind of glad to see the snow here. It's going to be better for the racers.
Okay, folks, here we are at the Angel Fire Shovel Races Super Modified 25th Anniversary. We've had one run come down. We're going to try to make sure we get the rest of it for you. I'm sitting here with Bob the Man. Wave to the camera, Bob.
What's happening?
And we're hanging out, and we're going to get all this footage for us, all right? So thank you very much, and we'll catch you later.
Obscurity. Is he okay?
Yeah.
Fine.
Get busy time. Get busy time. Get busy time. Get busy time.
I guess I didn't know.
Get busy time. Get busy.
I guess I didn't know.
Get busy. Get busy.
I guess I didn't know.
Get busy.
I guess I didn't know.
Just not Corey out of third place. This is gonna have to be the run. Smooth as can be. How did the steering work?
Steering worked great. Steering worked great. Every slightest little move, turns.
Excellent.
Straighten you right up.
How'd the brake feel?
Oh, it stopped me. Quick.
Did it pull on your harness?
It was done.
And were you screaming inside, cheering?
Yeah, I was just woo.
All right.
Couldn't get my arms out to go.
All right. Here comes Don.
He's not going to.
Yeah, look
yeah
at
this.
He is.
Okay.
Good job.
Good job.
That's good. Gail Boles, the current world champion.
Go left ball.
Woo! What do you got? How much did he get?
Yeah!
All right, Spring Swan.
Woohoo, baby! Three-Peat!
Like most things in life, this one starts simply. Can you see? This is simply a guy and, under him, a shovel. A guy named Gail Boles sitting and sliding on the snow on a shovel.
So let's take a moment here just to pause and think about the shovel. Okay.
Shovels do things to guys like Gail.
Hair goes up on the back of my neck and the adrenaline starts pumping.
At his job, Gail's a pharmacist, but in his heart, he's a shovel racer. an athlete in a mountainside snow sport that moved from to, yeah, this is Gail's shovel craft, made of indie-style steel, sitting on a couple of Canadian skis. Guess where the shovel is? Not there. Not there. Under here.
That's a regular Ames number 12 grain scoop.
Ready? Mm-hmm.
And Gail goes in here, and the rack and pinion steering wheel goes, well, it makes sense why Gail has to go without the meatloaf and mashed potato dinners, because...
What if you gain a few pounds?
Well, then you fit a little tighter, or you got to hire another driver.
But there's no better driver than Gail Boles. He's the three-time world champion shovel racer. Want to see a pro in action?
So, just like those sports guys say, let's go to the videotape. Wrong tape. That's the 1932 Winter Olympics. We need the 1998 World Champion Shovel Race tape. Have you got it, and could you roll it?
Woo! Gail beat out 15 other shovel racers.
It just takes no fear.
His top speed? About 80 miles an hour.
So there ain't never one time that I don't have adrenaline in my system.
Or a crowd at his contraption.
Oh, I think it's crazy.
But could it, would it make it at the Winter Olympics?
It's not quite as graceful as ice dancing.
Oh, no.
But the stars suffered just as much.
Manly men doing masculine things.
You know, for all his effort and hard work, this guy deserves something great. I'll be right back. Yeah.
For excellence in his field, Gail Boles gets the gold. Shovel. All dreams start somewhere. Bill Wood, 13 News, with a postcard from somewhere in the Sandia Mountains.
That's great. Now that's digging for the gold.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe they've struck pay dirt.
Come on, Pete, let's burn some asses. Talking in the kitchen late last night. Yeah, I heard my mama tell my papa. She said, you better stop that boy staying out all night long. Better stop that boy staying out all night long. Tell the break of day. The boogie, the boogie. Baby, tell the break of day. And I heard my papa tell my mama, baby, you better leave that boy alone. Girl, our boy got something deep inside him now. If it don't come out right, you know it's gonna come out wrong. It don't come out right, it's gonna come out wrong. Come out wrong. Come out wrong. Come out wrong. They talk about the boogie, yeah, the boogie. Baby, tell the break it. Thank you. Give me one.
Stay up till 4 in the morning and just like me last night.
Why did you?
I did that the other working night. On the Lexan, getting it all done.
Gentlemen, do you have anything to say about your tremendous victory?
Oh, just a little thing.
We'll do it again next year, buddy.
This morning I had to get up. I was pretty bad shape this morning. I had to get up and get some huevos rancheros so I'd have to have those extra 2 nuts to get me down the hill safely.
Okay, folks, here we are, the shovel races. It's the weird cosmic shovel races of the threes. This is Don Adkins' 3rd shovel race. Chris Jacob took 3. Corey took 3rd. Gail has won 3 in a row. Kim has won 3 in a row.
Where is Kim?
The Shovelmeister's won 1-2-3 in production, 1-2-3 in modified. Need I say more?
Took her own life a few weeks ago, and rather than have a moment of silence, I really think this lady would rather have us all raise your glasses in toast to a lady that helped make show racing cool. Give a toast. She's not here with us, to Missy Bowles, please. I was overcome with emotion. She's won the event before. She blew everybody's doors out. She had a time almost a full second faster than the second place racer. She's going to get $300. She's going to get a plaque. She's going to get a jacket. She's going to get glass work from Bowles in the works with a time 19.8. Helped started this thing a long time ago. Yeah! Bob Harney. He's going to get $200, a plaque, a belt buckle, a bunch of stuff from Budweiser with a time of 18.955. A guy who's been around this a long time. Let's bring up Woody Harney. Speed, he's about a three-time champion.
All right, Pat!
He had a time of 18.535, almost a half a second faster than anybody else.
Yeah.
He's gonna get $300. He's gonna get a plaque, a belt buckle, jacket, glassware, shirts, hats, all sorts of stuff for fun. From Edmond, Oklahoma, Patrick Burgess! Division 21-44. In third place with a time of 17.383. He's gonna get $100, a plaque, a belt buckle. Let's bring up Terry Burge.
Whoa! Yeah. I thought it was Jacob.
From Dumber Racing.
All right,
for Scott Cassetti.
Kent should be second, and Chris should be third.
The results were wrong, and some people have received their awards and my adulations unwarranted. However, a famous saying around Angel Fire in all of New Mexico, it's not my job. Anyway, we're going to get it straightened out here, and then we're going to bring these guys up, and it would be horribly remiss, and we're going to bring them up here because, like I said before, we had a mistake in the tabulations. No, the same mistake, I'm just repeating myself. Kind of sounds like announcing the production races. Anyway, okay, I think we ought to bring these guys up, absolutely, because this guy got third place, he's going to get a plaque, he's going to get a bag, he's going to get some cash. He had a good time of 17.306. Let's bring up Chris Dracop.
just want to say, y'all, we said a little thing about Missy, and I just want to say this is definitely for her, and thanks a lot. Let's hear y'all make some noise for the lady. Yeah.
The guy who actually plays second in the event, and he's going to get some money and a plaque. And the rightful second place with a time of 17.144 he's raced in this event a long time. Let's bring up Kent Hutchie. For years and years, but he finally made it to the top of his category. He's gonna get $300, a plaque, a belt buckle, jacket, glassware, cool stuff from Bud. Let's bring up Chad Denny. Because she was the fastest woman to ever come down this race course. She's gonna get a plaque. She's gonna get some cool stuff from Bud. Let's give her a round of applause. She had a time of 14.685. She went 72 miles an hour from Houston, Texas. Let's bring up Lizzie. It's a long name. Elizabeth Winningham, bring her up. After his first run, he went to Snow Summit last year and immediately became a media darling.
Kermit.
Everyone loved him. He's huggable, he's cute. He had a time of 14.078. He represents what shovel racing is all about. He's going to get $100 and a bunch of cool stuff from Bud. Let's bring up the pilot of the Kermitator, Kermit Brown. Place. He had a fast time. The first time he said down the course was the hardest run he's ever had just to keep it on the course. He fought it all the way down. A little story on Friday, his trial run, he put his face mask down and his whole face mask fogged up and he went down the course blind. He couldn't see a thing. But he said he was riding in a Cadillac because he's been in a lot of rickety machines, but he was in a beauty today built by Rob Villalobos. This guy has been racing in the shovel races for 23 years. That's a long time. And he certainly gets the award for longevity for shovel race modified speed pilots. He's gonna get $200. He's gonna get an Ames jacket, a belt buckle, some cool stuff from Bud. He had a time of 13.960, and he posted the fastest mile per hour of the day at 78 miles per hour. From Edmond, Oklahoma, let's bring up Pat Burgess. In third place, he piloted a machine that won this event 2 years in a row. It used to be called Thor's Hammer. I think it's now
ready
called
for our drinks, man.
Four times.
It is a fast machine. He's going to get $500, a plaque, an Ames jacket, a belt buckle, some cool stuff from Budweiser. He went real fast, 13.958. Let's bring up first time modified speed pilot Corey Humphrey. And also, if you would like to get involved and be a pilot or an owner, I don't know if I'd buy a used modified shovel race from Rob Villalobos, but it's got to be better than Nixon. I don't know. Okay, let's get on with this. In second place, he won the 1997 Winter X Games. This guy did what Gallus Greco gets paid lots of money for, and that's to make fast chassis and things. He makes his own. He not only made one that he got second place on, he helped make the one that got first place. This guy has the need for speed. He got second place last year in the World Shovel Race Championships. He's going to get $750. He's going to get a plaque, an Ames jacket, a belt buckle, glassware, cool stuff from Budweiser. Let's bring up 13.882, Don Adkins!
And now.
And now the moment we've all been waiting for. We've never had a three-peat in modified speed. If you watched ESPN last year, you saw the most spectacular crash that went worldwide. And he came back after that crash and won here in Angel Fire. This guy was racing on a machine that Don Adkins helped build. He's been a two-time men's production champion, and he is now a three-time modified speed champion. He's gonna get $1,000. He's gonna get a plaque, an Ames jacket, a belt buckle, some cool shit from Budweiser in the time of 13.801. Let's bring up Gail
much. Yeah, it was a horrific crash I had last year along with some of my teammates and stuff, but anyways, this is the sport. Come on, Olympics. What about the Olympics now, huh? You guys, Kermit, all these guys, you want the Huns to come back? What is up with that? You guys, you're coming back. All right. Well, this is the first sled that I've ever actually built, been a part of building. Don Adkins, Butch Johansson, my friend Andy Dobos, helping me with my skis. Couldn't have done without him. People said, you can't build a sled, all right? You gotta buy your way into it. Well, guess what? I built a sled, and I won with that sled, baby, all right? I wanna thank, I got a couple of sponsors. You can build a sled, get some sponsors. Ultra Nectar, Coors, Harley Davidson. I'm gonna thank you. This is Andy Dobos, my friend since sixth grade. Anyways, I love Angel Fire. We love these guys. We're glad they're keep putting it on. This is a really special, special 25th anniversary race. I tried so hard. I've worked all year on this sled, and it's a kick. I love this stuff. I love this stuff. Oh yeah, that's right, Coors. Sorry about that, bud, but Coors sponsors me, so. Hey. Anyways, thank you guys. And also, I'd like to say, and I guess it's a redundant issue, but Mitzi Howell is a good, good friend of ours. And we'll miss her, and her spirit will always be here with us. She's a six-time champion. Anyways, thanks a lot. Come back next year, take me on, huh? I'll be back.
Rock and roll back up here.
A little dedication to Carl Wilson.
It should be bigger. It should be like.
Yeah, I know. It should be at least 800.
He's
thinking of a shovel.
Shovel race of the threes. Let me explain the threes. It's Donnie's third shovel race. Kim Romero has won three shovel races in a row. Gail Boles has won three modified shovel races in a row. Corey took third. Dracob took third.